Cállate, niños! Go ahead and bite this time, Clara. I prepare. You know what? I am going to knock you out with chloroform. I am going to put you out in a sack, and I'm going to bury you alive. And if you think I'm kidding, look over there. Clara, I prepare. I have the whole shebang ready. Comprendes? Mm-hmm. Well, very good. Would either of you like breakfast?
Yes, please. Me too, please.
Good. And if you play your cards right, I have a surprise for you.
We have a surprise for you, too.
One and two and one and two and one and two and one and two and three and four and one and two 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 and three and four. Three sets. 1, 2, 3.
Hey, mister. Is that any way to act? You know I care about you, and I want only good things for you, and I empower you to embrace them for your own. And embrace and release. And embrace and release.
Paul?
What?
Come over here. I'm really worried about my spine. Feel that right there? Feel that. You feel that, right? You know, some of the girls at the crisis center feel that I might have adult scoliosis. What do you think about that?
There's no such thing.
What is the use? Forget about it. I am an egg full of female potential. I am an egg.
Here's your ex.
Oh, Clara, doorbell.
I didn't hear nothing.
You know, we met our fundraising goal at the Crisis Center. They're giving me a big plaque today. It reads Trevor Van Arsdale, Women's Crusader. I'm telling you, Paul, my self-esteem is just going through the roof. You coming to the luncheon, right?
Sorry, babe, I've got another ribbon cutting. Just finished that new mini mall.
Another one? Where are they putting this one?
You know at 7th and Hill, that big old banyan tree you could drive a truck through?
Yes.
Well, we did. They need me there.
They need you here, they need you there. I guess I'll just have to go to the crisis center and tell them that I am the only woman there whose husband does not care enough about her to support her efforts.
What about me and my efforts, huh? Did you know I'm going to be the only senior partner who's there without his wife or his mistress? Everybody's busy today. How do you think that makes me feel?
Neglected?
Yes.
I feel neglected, too.
Sorry, Pumpkin. We've been neglecting each other.
Oh. It's like they say at the crisis center, neglect is the most insidious form of abuse. Mm-hmm. Let's do ourselves a favor. Stop the neglect. That's what they say.
Mm-hmm. There was nobody there.
Sorry, I must have made a mistake. We finished our breakfast. It was yummy. Yeah, now, how about that surprise?
Oh, no. I'm wearing my gold toe ring. What am I trying to remind myself of? Why am I wearing my gold toe ring?
Because we're so wealthy we've lost the value of money.
No, that is ridiculous. We love money. I am serious, Paul. Please try and help me. What am I forgetting?
Muchas felicidades para Jason and B. Jason? B? Ay, Dios mío, ayúdame!
Wait a minute, isn't it the twins' birthday today?
You're asking me?
I quit! send my final check to mi casa in Managua. And if the money's not there by the end of the week, I am going to send some cousins to slit your throats with machetes while you're asleep.
Clara, please, can't we just talk this out?
There's nothing to talk about, senora. Your children are evil, and I must leave before they turn into the Manfreds.
You mean the Mansons?
Whatever. Clara, please. Paul and I have a very big day today. I, for one, am getting another plan.
Shut up, you pathetic white lady.
A long numero cinco.
Great.
Who are we going to get now?
Wanted. Talented man ain't to care for two charming children.
That's a little misleading, isn't it?
Well, Poopy, what do you want me to say? Unsuspecting boob to care for aspiring pyros?
That'd be a little bit more accurate. Where are the kids anyway?
I punished them.
You did? What was the punishment?
I told them, in no uncertain terms, mind you, to watch it.
Whoa. And?
Went outside to light bugs on fire.
You know, for the life of me, I can't figure out why our kids are so wild. You know, we're both good-looking people. Maybe.
What?
Maybe it's our fault.
Oh, dear. Maybe we have been hiring the wrong kind of nanny to raise our children for us.
Mom? Dad,
go away.
Kids, we're busy. We have to place a new ad for a nanny.
Relax. We already did it for you. Ready?
Ready. Easy job, lots of pay, sitting on your butt all day.
Watch TV, sleep all you want, get takeout from a restaurant.
Let our kids play and stay up late while you zone out and masticate. What? It means to chew.
So, what do you think?
Justin.
Jason.
Jason, haven't you done enough already to disrupt our morning? Now go upstairs and play.
Do you want to play with us?
You know Daddy can't play with you in his good clothes.
But you don't have any bad clothes.
Oh, thank you, honey. That's sweet. Now you have fun. I'll come by later and give you your birthday checks, okay?
But I didn't get any cake.
Come here.
Stop it. You're going to give your mother a headache.
No, that's impossible. I've already had 3 Seconds.
Come on. Come on.
Make sure to print lots of copies.
Gracia, you go first.
Okay.
Paul. Paul, look at this. This is written as a poem. I think they get that from me. You know, I was very artistic as a child. I started wearing makeup when I was 6.
Can't we just talk this over? Oh. But I really don't want to go.
Warden, please. Warden. Warden, why are you doing this?
Edie. If I had my way, you'd be on the lock and key for the rest of your sorry days. As far as I'm concerned, you are living proof that on occasion, God makes mistakes. You don't deserve oxygen, let alone freedom. But with the budgets I'm facing, I have to make way for the next batch of slime balls to be produced by this permissive society. So you go on out there and try to live a decent life, okay?
Decent? I don't know the meaning of the word. I'll never make it out there.
The United States government is well aware of your difficult transition. So here's $20 and an outfit from Target. Get lost!
I'll never make it to the edge of town in this thing. Please, I want to stay with you guys.
Will you listen to yourself, Edie? Nobody wants to be locked up in jail.
I do. I've been in and out of this place since I was 14, and I've come to think of jail as a special place. You don't have to worry about rent or bills or personal hygiene. You can lay in bed all day and watch soap operas and write disturbing fan mail. When you think of it, jail is like a wonderful hotel, and I, for one, never want to check out.
You deserve the chair for that speech, Edie.
No, wait. You can't let me go! You can't let me go! I'm dangerous.
Dangerous?
Yeah.
Only to a box of donuts. Now wipe your gaping jaw and get out of here. I said get out. Get out. You're holding up my lunch. Get out.
Okay. I'm going. Look. Here I go. Bye. Thanks.
Okay, now, let's get this ad written. I can't be late for my massage.
Poopy, I think I've done it. Listen to this. Stern individual wanted, must be well-versed in the lost art of discipline. Extremists welcome. Our children are like ugly lumps of deformed clay. We need you to mold them into something beautiful.
Deform clay, mold them. I like it.
So? Told you I was artistic. Speaking of clay, where is my pottery wheel?
Xylophone tuner? No. Yarn spinner. What's that? Zucchini picker. Nah. Well, that's that.
I'll hire you. I need somebody to lift up the windshield wipers while I wash underneath. Too lazy to work, huh?
No. Just don't have any experience.
Too bad nobody's looking. For one taster, you'd be employee of the month.
Has anyone told you you smell like the bottom of a rabbit cage?
Bottom? Well, that's where all the poop... Oh, I get it. You know, you remind me of how I used to be. Drunk, bitter. But don't worry, it gets better. Look at me now.
God help me.
Easy job, lots of pay, sitting on your butt all day.
Hallelujah! I'm here for the job.
Right this way, Stau.
The word is Frau.
What a great house.
My parents will be down in a minute. Can I get you anything in the meantime? Like a big stinky sausage?
Doesn't look good.
No kidding. What circus train crashed?
Oh, I hope they have a big TV.
what we asked for in our ad.
I know. Check it out.
Hey, this isn't ours. Oh, great. Now we'll never find a cool nanny.
Thank you. Hi.
Hi.
This your ad?
Yeah. Right this way, ma'am. Watch your step.
Huh? Oh, yeah.
Now, why in the world would we hire someone like you to take care of our precious twins?
Because I love children.
Honey, please, let's try to be realistic.
Sorry. Ask me something else.
Look at that one slipping it off. It smells like a brewery.
It's filthy.
It stinks.
You know, there's a dog in here. I smell one. Yeah, allergic to it.
This is ridiculous. Thought I was falling.
I'm staying 5 more minutes. There's no way Mom and Dad are gonna go for her. The competition's just too stiff.
Well, we'll just have to fix that, won't we? My sister and I are really cruel to animals.
Yeah.
Oh, you children seem perfectly sweet to me. But I must warn you, if you try to do anything to Bobo, he's been trained to chew on your faces until they look like hamburger. Isn't that right, Bobo?
You know what my favorite thing to do is? I like to go booger hunting.
So what? A lot of people like to pick their nose.
Oh, I don't like to pick my own nose.
Try the left nostril. I've been eating a lot of dairy lately.
Are you a man?
No.
You're the same size as my dad. He'll like that.
Why?
So he can borrow your clothes. He's special.
Hey, yeah. Maybe we can make a trade. I always like wearing jock straps.
If this doesn't work, we're gonna end up with one witch of a nanny. Now, you take care of our ringer. Check.
I'm just about to take. I forget what.
Okay, ladies. Before we distribute applications, my parents would like you to take a tour of the property. Now, follow me.
Oh, it's about time.
Come on, here we go. Shh. You stay here.
And this is the side yard.
Fresh air.
Hey, ladies, come on, please, listen up. Boy, there sure are a lot of you applying for this one job. Are you all aware that there's only one position to fill?
Yeah, absolutely.
You all must really need work. Oh, bills to pay, I bet. Now, to be honest, we weren't really expecting such a turnout. In fact, we only have one application. Now the question is, who gets the application?
All right.
I want to make this fair. Well, the truth of the matter is, you all seem like really lovely people to me.
Oh, well.
So the application goes to whoever fills it out first.
We're looking for someone who can remain calm in a crisis.
Pardon me, Poopy, but don't you think that that might frighten away just a few of our prospective nannies?
Okay, let me rephrase that. We're looking for someone who likes surprises.
Hey, wait a minute.
This is an unemployment application.
Yeah, well, you're gonna need it because the position's already been filled.
I'm worried. What if no one shows up? I mean, when you think about it, only a moron would want to take care of our children.
Relax, honey. With any luck, we'll have a moron waiting for us in the next room.
Edie? This is my mom and dad. Mom and dad, Edie.
That was a really cute ad you placed. It was,
Edie's the only one who showed up.
Well, perhaps we should wait and see if any others show up, just to be fair.
Well, suit yourself. But, you know, I would be perfect for this job.
Oh.
Oh, dear. Whoops.
Oh.
Excuse me. I had grapes for breakfast.
Oh, you do? So do I. Tons of them. They help keep my eyes clear.
Me too.
Trouble. Excuse me, do you have a resume?
She gave it to us, but we threw it in the trash. Sorry, sometimes we're naughty.
Well, I only brought the one. I believe that is customary.
Of course that's customary. Jason, B, we need to speak to Miss Edie alone. It's a grown-up business.
Don't forget to tell them about all your experience.
I won't.
Edie, why don't we sit down? So, how long have you been a nanny?
Not for too long. I just got out of finishing school.
Finishing school? Well, 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 I like that.
Who was your last employer?
The Kennedys.
The Kennedys? Paul, did you hear that? The Kennedys.
Yes, I heard that. That's very impressive. What exactly did you do for the Kennedys?
Beg pardon?
That's the crisis center. I counsel people who are messed up. Sad.
Hello. Oh, hi, Jacques. When? Yeah, I could leave today. That's great news. I'll see you in Paris.
Excuse me. Paris, what's all this about Paris? When are you going to Paris?
This afternoon. Can you believe it? After 2 years of negotiations, I'm finally going international. Trevor, they approved my plans to put a mini mall in Paris. You want to know the kicker? It's going right next to the Eiffel Tower. They'll look great together. I've got to make travel plans.
Yes, we'll meet at a flight for two. You know how much I love Paris, and we haven't been there in weeks. It'll be so great to parlez-vous again. Of course, those crazies at the crisis center will have to cool their heels for a bit, but I deserve a little me time, don't you think?
Trevor, who's going to watch the kids?
Our new nanny.
We don't know anything about her. She could be anybody. You, a convict.
Nonsense, Paul. If she's good enough for the Kennedys, she's good enough for us.
I don't know.
If I don't go, then you don't go. And if you don't go, then Paris doesn't get its first mini mall. Now it's your decision.
Edie, you're hired.
Huh?
Yeah! 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 Yeah!
We'll be home at the end of the week.
Yes. Now, here's the combination to the burglar alarm. I want you to use it, Edie. You know, these days, criminals are just roaming around in the streets.
Yeah, I know. It's awful.
And here are the keys to the station wagon. My apologies. It is not Thorn.
Oh, well.
Here is the hotel that we're going to be staying at. Please feel free to call any time. Isn't it gorgeous? The French, they know how to live.
Well, you know, you don't do so bad yourselves.
Thank you.
Money isn't everything, Edie. Oh, maybe it is.
He is so crazy. I guess maybe that's where the kids get it from.
Oh, by the way, Edie, don't let them push you around. They can do that, can't they, Paul?
Yeah, well, I'm sure I can manage.
We want you to do more than just manage. We want you to whip them into shape. We want you to teach them some manners. We want you to get them under control. You think you can do that?
Of
course she can do that, Paul. Look how well behaved those Kennedy children are.
Now,
darling, we better go. We're going to miss our plane.
I'll go get the kids.
No, there's no time. Just tell them we said goodbye.
A bientôt.
God!
Jason! Aha, you fell for it! Hey, V, it worked! Come here!
Oh, my God.
Jason, what is wrong with you? You just about gave your father a heart attack. Are you okay, Sherry? V, honey, you recycle that bottle.
Get out of the way.
Bye! We love you!
Yeah. Get back in there.
Get inside! Go! Get out of the street! Hey, that's my mom's dress.
Oh, yeah. Well, she told me to feel free to rummage.
That doesn't sound like her.
Hey. Okay. These are the rules. You can do anything you want. Just don't ever get between me and that.
Good morning. Welcome to another episode of Thug Search.
That's it.
Today we're tracking the gruesome.
That's it. Now go. You're on your own.
Cool. Don't let this sweet expression awesome. This young face fool you. For although he is only 13 years old, this eighth grader is responsible for over 37 deaths in the tri-state area.
Now it's time for the Adrian Wexler Jones Show.
Hey, you little snots, keep it down.
Welcome to my show. I'm Adrian Wexler Jones. Today we're talking about a shocking subject, the selling of children for profit. I know. Stay tuned.
Kids, if you're gonna break stuff, go outside.
Okay, here's the story.
Last year, this couple, who we will call the Smiths. Now, do you want me to tell them that you're in disguise?
That's fine.
Okay. They're in disguise. They had their child sold right out from under them. Now, I understand that your wife is too upset to speak.
Yes.
I'm glad that she could be here anyway. Now, you tell me what happened.
One day, we had just spent a lovely day with our little six-year-old. And when we got home, we found a little notice in the mail with an airline ticket that said that I just want a free trip to Alaska. Keep it together. We put him on a plane.
Wait, alone?
We don't like the snow.
No, we do not. And we are entitled.
That's right, yes. Yes.
Let's go. So, within 6 or 7 weeks, we hadn't heard from her, and we began to get suspicious. And that's when we found out that our little boy had been sold, like a t-shirt on the beach. Something I don't know, maybe I should burn.
All right, we have to take a break.
But there's more. I'm not finished.
All right, this is my show. I have to break. There are no choices.
Don't go away, folks.
Hey, Jason, give me a beer, will ya? Jason,
yet.
Beer!
It's late beer, huh? That's not pretty.
You can't talk.
Why not?
Oh, I know a lot of things.
Because I taped his mouth shut.
How many feet are in a mile?
It's weird. When you pinch his nose, he turns blue.
That's because he's suffocating, you nitwit. Now go untape him. Get me a beer first.
Welcome back. With us now is Detective Daryl Bristol, who's considered to be an expert on the topic of child selling.
Thank you for coming, Detective. In your opinion, will the Smiths ever see their child again?
It's a toss-up.
Smiths, you've had your turn. Okay. I'm sorry, Detective. Why would someone want to sell a child?
That's easy, Miss Jones. Money.
It's Ms. Wexler Jones. Sorry, but I've earned it. Okay. What kind of money are we talking about?
Thousands and thousands of dollars, I'm afraid.
Okay. Now, this is going to sound sick, but I'm a talk show host.
And my public counts on me to examine the issues.
Of course.
Okay. Is the child market like any other market? In other words, do some children fetch higher prices than others?
Absolutely. This season, blonde children are bringing in higher prices.
Interesting.
What you watching?
Nothing. Go away.
I brought your beer. You're mean. We thought you were going to be nice.
Oh, sorry. Look, why don't you go in the kitchen and order some pizza for dinner?
You gave us pizza for lunch.
You liked it, didn't you?
Yeah.
Well, knock yourselves out.
Yay!
You are nice!
So here you have it. Your basic child is worth 10 grand, like your kid. Oh, add 2 grand for blonde hair. Add another 2 grand for talkers.
So that means that they can talk.
Yeah, talkers. And of course, if you have twins, identical or fraternal.
That's quite exotic. So you can add another 5 grand each.
Wow. So if you had a pair of blonde twins around age, say, 8, that would be, in this sick scenario, something pretty valuable.
That's right. Each blonde
twin would be worth $19,000.
That's a lot of money.
Kids, order as much pizza as you want.
Tonight, we celebrate.
Holiday Inn.
Elliot, it's me. Got a business proposition for you.
Hang on a sec.
Okay.
Yeah, sure, go ahead. Uh-huh. Uh-huh. Blonde twins?
Hey, they are valuable.
All I need is a buyer. I thought that's where you might come in.
Yeah, I might be able to connect you with some interested parties. What's my cut?
I don't know. Just thinking like 10%, you know, like a Hollywood agent gets. Well, okay, 20. That's not fair. That's not fair. I'm doing all the work. You're just farting around in jail.
Hey, listen, you friggin' moron. The only reason I'm in here in the first place is because of you. You owe me.
I said I was sorry. What more do you want?
What I want is a little confidence.
Shh! Shut up! I'm sleeping!
Couldn't you have done any research? Jeez.
We've been through this before. Now, look. Robbing houses is risky. This... Basically.
Yeah, well, not if you don't find the right buyers, you don't. And for that, you're gonna need me.
I want 50%. Have we got a deal?
Deal.
Good. All right, now stop eating.
I got somebody for you to call.
What a lousy driver.
Well, it's been a while since the last time I drove a car.
The word is driven. And why has it been so long?
Because I'm used to being chauffeured. I'm used to finery. Class. Stop asking me questions. Look for 424 Wilton.
Who are we visiting all the way out here?
Uncle. Your parents asked me to take you. Stop asking questions.
But both of our parents were only children. How could we have an uncle?
B, it is my sad duty to inform you that sometimes adults lie. You have an uncle.
Are you Manny?
Yeah. Where are the Rugrats?
They're in the car. But before you meet them, there are some things I gotta tell you.
Yeah. Got it.
wonder Mom never told us about her brother. He lives in a crapper.
I have a very specialized operation. I rob toy stores. Nothing but. So what I need are a couple of brats to create a diversion. You know, break stuff, fight, while I empty out the cash registers.
Sounds like a good plan.
So you think your kids are bratty enough for the job?
There's your answer. Load them up with pizza, and they'll do anything you want.
Well, bring them in. I'm sure they're anxious to meet their Uncle Manny. And this is where you sleep.
Oh. Where are the sheets?
There aren't any. Less to wash.
What's that?
That's my pet.
Is it a mouse or a rat?
Well, you know, I've had it so long I can't remember. But I wouldn't bother him if I were you.
What's this for?
I use it, my line of work.
What do you do?
Just give it back.
What do I get if I do?
I think you should be more worried about what you get if you don't. I use it because I'm a chef. Yeah, I make pizza.
Pizza? Cool!
Hey, kids. How would you like to stay here with your Uncle Manny? It'll be lots of fun. You can play with the oil and all the flammable stuff.
Will you make us pizza?
Already have. Look in there.
Ooh. Good about the pizza.
Yeah, thanks. I thought of that on the spot.
Can we have some now?
Sure. Edie and I need to talk anyway.
How do we cook it?
I like it frozen.
Okay, let's get down to brass tacks. They cost $19,000 each.
That's funny. I give you five for both.
They're worth $19,000.
Look, they're worth what I'm willing to pay, and I'm only willing to pay five.
They're blonde twins.
I wouldn't care if they had red hair and so many freckles it looked like somebody threw dog crap at them through a screen door.
Shh.
I'm looking for brats, and I'm only gonna pay five.
It's not enough.
All right, fine. But when those rich folks get back from Frogtown, and they find out the truth about their ex-con nanny, they'll give you your walking papers. You'll be out on the street with nothing, and you'll wish you had $5,000 then.
You're ripping me off. All right, where's the money? Can't wait to get out of this stinkhole you call it. Office.
Let's see what we got here. $100. $200. $300.
Hey, I found your gun. And I found your pet.
Get the hell out of here and take your wiggy brats with you. Go on, beat it. Oh, that's gross.
Elliot, it's not the end of the world. Take that to the kids upstairs, all right? Take the money out of their piggy banks.
I don't know. They just got a gun and blew a hole in the wall.
Upstairs on the right. Be careful, they like to play tricks.
I don't know what you're so mad about. He said he wanted brats, and I gave him brats. Now, look, I can't get into this now. I got brownies in the microwave. You got somebody else?
Yeah, a couple named White. Look, and this time you don't even have to worry about negotiating price. They're willing to pay $8,000 for each.
Elliot, they're worth $19,000 apiece. I saw it on the Adrian Wexler Jones show.
Edie, look, do us both a favor, all right? Just
tomorrow morning, just take the kids over there, get the money, and split. You got it?
Got it.
Good. Oh, and make sure and look sharp. The Whites aren't like you. They got class.
For your information, I've changed a lot since the last time you saw me.
Oh, my God! Oh, my God! I'm on fire! Help me! I'm burning! I'm burning!
Jason!
The pizza wasn't hot enough! backyard, playing mud hen.
I told you we got some more of your relatives to meet today, and you look like a couple of slobs. Now get back in the house and change your clothes, and hurry it up!
We don't have any clean clothes. Yeah, this is day 3 for my underwear.
Take it off.
I want to store something clean. We're gonna have to do some laundry.
I got a better idea. Get in the car. Move it! Get in the car! Hurry it up! Hurry it up! I haven't got all day! What do you think this is? There. What do you think?
I don't like brown. I look like a walking turd.
Well, go find something else.
Really? My mom never lets me do that.
Yeah? Well, I'm a lot nicer than your mom. Now move your ass. Well, I'm just weighing it. Hmm, nice and light. Hey, that's a pretty dress.
Thanks.
You're welcome.
You didn't take the perfume out yet.
Oh, whoops. Now, I'll meet you over by the entrance, okay? Bye.
Lovely scent, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
I like it, too. It drives me wild. Too bad you're not my type. I'm a bit of a chubby chaser. That's my cup of tea. I figure you to be a single mom, the unkempt kids, the weary stance, the tragic ambiance. I'm sorry. I have this horrible habit of getting too personal too fast. It's just that there's so many rotten people in the world today, like my ex-wife. Should die, preferably slowly. But you know, I feel that when you find someone good, you should open up to them. I can just tell that you're one of the good ones. And I'm a very cynical person.
Hey, Edie, you left this in the dressing room.
That's not mine. Oh, that's disgusting. Now, go meet me by the entrance. You know, he's this close to being retarded.
Oh, how sad. He looks so normal.
Look, I'm gonna head on over to the baby department. You know, get him a teething ring so he doesn't slobber all over his new clothes. And I'll just, I'll pay for everything over there.
Sure. And put on some weight. Mother's milk.
Oh, wait, get the tags,
We didn't pay for anything.
Doesn't matter.
What's this?
Uh-oh, are we gonna get arrested?
Not if you shut up and get in the car. We're gonna be late for the whites.
Who are the whites?
Let's go!
Oh, hello. You must be Jason and B. I'm your Aunt Rita, and this is your uncle, Uncle Jack. Jack?
Hello.
Which side of the family are you from?
We're from the good side. Oh, take off your shoes.
Why?
Just do it, little girl. Well, this is it.
Yep. Jack calls it the White House. Isn't that fun?
Yeah. Well, when you think about it, our last name is White, and we like using a lot of white in our decor, so I just thought of it one night, the White House!
Hello, Mr. President.
Ooh, I pledge allegiance to you. Oh. Get your fingers off that molding! Now, let's go inside, shall we?
My, you certainly smell clean.
It's perfume. Edie tried to steal it along with these clothes.
Oh, well, they charge such high prices. Speaking of which...
Is there some place the kids could go play while we, spoke?
Oh, yeah. Of course. Jack?
Yeah. We've arranged for you to have some pizza, but you're gonna have to eat it outside because I'm afraid we don't allow anything made with tomato sauce indoors. All right?
Pizza? Cool!
Yeah, way cool. Yeah, go on now. Go. Right through there. Go on now.
Yeah.
Go on. Go.
Wow, even their dog is white.
They certainly are clean children.
Yeah, much better than common orphanage stock.
Mm-hmm. And cute, too.
Yeah.
You know, some kids are just plain hideous. I know that probably sounds cruel, but we are talking a lot of money here.
$8,000 apiece, right?
We've been through so many interviews. You see, Rita and I can't have children. It's a very painful subject for us.
Oh, well, I understand. You really don't need to say any more.
But we like to talk about it. Rita and I were both born normal. You know, fertile.
Mm-hmm. Eggs.
Sperm, mm-hmm. The whole thing.
Yeah.
But shortly after we were married, we had ourselves sterilized.
Everything that happens down in that area is so messy. We thought, why not fix the problem?
Yeah, so we had everything ripped out, pinched, or cauterized, and we didn't think twice.
Until?
Until what?
Until we realized that we would make dynamite parents.
I couldn't agree with you more. Now, why don't I just go ahead and take the money?
Hold it, Missy. We're not sure that we want your children yet.
But they're clean and neat. You said so yourself.
Edie, I'd like to tell you a little story. When I was 7 years old, all I wanted for Christmas was a little white wagon. So I told my parents, and sure enough, on Christmas morning, there it was. Oh, boy. I went everywhere with it. Till one day I noticed that there was a chip in the paint. And you know what was underneath? Red. Yeah. My parents had just taken a red wagon and painted it white. Don't you see, Edie? I had been fooled by the two people that I trusted the most in the world. And from that day forward, I vowed two things. Number one, that my parents would be forced into a convalescent hospital as soon as possible.
Mm-hmm.
And number two, that I would never let appearances fool me again.
So, what are you saying?
What we are saying is that we need to make sure that your children are predisposed to neatness and order.
We're saying that we'd like to put them through a little test.
Mm-hmm. Just a little.
Yeah. All right, Jason. It's very simple. There's a piece of lint somewhere on my person. All you have to do is find it and remove it. All right?
Why are they making us do this?
For the money. I mean, for the play money. It's a game. By the way, you did really well identifying those cleansers strictly by smell.
Thanks. It's fun to sniff vapors.
Yeah, I'm proud of you.
That's the first time anyone's ever said that to me.
Now, if I were a piece of lint, where would I be?
Hurry up and find it, little boy. I don't like knowing there's a foreign object on me. Mm. Oh. I'm beginning to get the heebie-jeebies. Mm. Please find it soon, Jason.
I'm looking. Relax.
He wants me to relax. Listen, mister. I'm doing this for your benefit. Now you shut your trap and find that lint. Oh, I can practically feel it burning a hole through my sweater.
Oh.
Mm. Look up higher, Jason. Listen to me. I just told you it was on my sweater.
Take it easy, Clinton. I'm right here.
Look, somewhere here on my torso, Jason, for crying out loud, find it.
Oh.
Ah, God, I feel like I've got a scorpion on me.
Are you all right?
No, I am not, Rita. What were we thinking? I mean, lint can consist of any number of disgusting things like flea eggs and pubic hair, and now it's on me, and this little pea brain can't even find it!
Get it, Jason.
Hurry up and find it before I'm completely disgusted!
Oh, boy, can't you see my husband's anatomy? Now you get it!
Find it!
Get it! Get it!
Find it!
Get it!
Yes, find it!
Get it, Jason, go!
Oh, dear God!
Oh, tomato sauce! Oh, God! Oh!
Thanks for wiping my face, Edie.
I was trying to slap it.
I'm glad we're not staying with Uncle Jack and Aunt Rita. They were weird.
You're weird, too, but we like you better.
Well, lucky me. I guess we're all just stuck with each other.
You know, you're not supposed to drink and drive. It's a crime.
Yeah, well, so is murder, Jason. So don't bug me.
Just trying to keep you out of jail.
Well, maybe that's where I belong.
Oh, don't say that. You're the first nanny we ever liked.
Oh, here, take it. It's empty anyway.
Hey, I'm barefoot!
Can we stop to get something to eat? I only got to rent that pizza.
Yeah. Yes, sir, that does sound disgusting. Goodbye.
Can't believe it!
I can't now, shut up!
She blew another sale. Oh, this ain't fair, Carl. I mean, she's as free as a bird on the outside, while I'm stuck in here. We were convicted of the same thing on the same day.
Yes, but she didn't stick a fondue fork in the warden's neck.
What are you, a parole board?
Just a friend.
I gotta get out of here before Edie blows everything. How are those uniforms coming?
Go ahead, get whatever you want.
I'll get the donuts, you get the chili. Check.
One lottery ticket.
Trying to get rich, huh?
Just give me the ticket.
What happened to America, huh? People used to work to get rich. Now they would rather rely on luck.
Spare me the sermon. Make it two.
If you ask me, you are already rich.
Well, I didn't ask him. For your information, I'm not rich. I'm poor. From the way things are going, I'll always be poor.
How can you say that you are poor when you have two beautiful, wonderful children such as those?
They're not really.
In my country, children are the most valuable things a person can have. They are a gift from God. They give you love. If only my wife and I could have children, we too would feel very rich. However, that is an impossibility.
Impotent, huh?
No, no, no. My unmentionables work just fine. And so do my wife's. We cannot have children because we cannot have sex. You see, my wife is from a different province than I am. And if I were ever to touch her in that special way, my glory would be chopped off and buried in a hole. So, we do not have sex. We do not have children. All we have is our precious little Lulu. She's so nice, so pretty. Oh, yeah, two hands, good girl.
That's the saddest story I've ever heard. Are children really that valuable to you?
Oh, yes.
How valuable, exactly?
18 and 19 and $20,000.
You should keep a lot of cash around here. No wonder these places are always getting robbed.
Hmm?
What'd she say?
She says she would like to thank you. She says you are a very generous person for selling your children to us. She says you are an angel and that you deserve everything you get.
Well, I guess I better be going now.
Oh, wait. Wouldn't you like to celebrate with us? Champagne!
Oh. Yeah, well, just a little nip couldn't hurt.
Ah, it's delicious.
Oh, interesting color.
It's from my homeland.
You're gonna love the kids. They're very well behaved. Last thing I said to them was, you stay right here and play with that sweet little monkey Lulu. Now, that was over 10 minutes ago, and you can bet your life that's exactly what they're doing right now.
Here's to Lulu.
And your new kids.
No, 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 no donuts! Oh! Oh,
Fabila!
We didn't mean to kill the monkey.
first 13 just fine.
You like the chili, too.
Yeah. Well, your little experiment cost me 20,000 duffers.
20,000 bucks? Whoa, that's an expensive monkey.
That's more than a car.
Shut up. Look, let me ask you kids a question. You have more toys, better food, and a nicer house than 99.9% of the world's entire population. So why are you such brats?
Because people let us.
You mean to tell me that no one in your entire lifetime has given you any rules to live by?
Well, you gave us one. Never come between you and the TV.
Oh, yeah, right. Well, guess what? Starting tomorrow, things are gonna change. Let's move it! You got 5 minutes to make your beds, brush your teeth, and get downstairs. Breakfast is waiting. Five, four, three, two, one.
I thought you said breakfast was waiting.
It is waiting. To be made. Now hurry up, I'm starving. If you don't hurry up, I'm gonna start cooking, and the only recipe I know is for liver. Are you guys in the mood for a nice piece of liver?
No, please, no!
I'm waiting. All right, now for every piece of junk you pick up in this room, you get to say one cuss word. Ready, set, go! Go, damn it, go! All right, divided by two, that's,
120.
Right, 120 cuss words apiece, catches. You gotta say them into this paper bag. Take that bag out to the garbage. Because that's where that kind of talk belongs. Catch you talking like that one more time, and I'll put you in the garbage and seal the lid. Got it?
Got it!
Do you have low self-esteem? If you're watching this program, you probably do. Well, now there's a revolutionary new method to help solve your problems.
Well, I prefer the old method.
Hi, I'm Kyle.
Hey!
I'm a mom.
Somebody get me a beer.
This is Christian. I just stepped out of the shower after a long day on the construction site. So what are you doing?
Here you go.
This is Pam. You know what I'd really
ma'am.
Like?
Oh. I'd like to meet here you go, ma'am.
Very nice.
Oh, you're
thank
awful.
You.
Would it be okay if we played a game now? We finished all our chores. Now the laundry, the dishes, everything.
Well, I guess you deserve it.
Do you want to play with us?
If you're lonely, call the chat line. Only $4.99 a minute.
Yeah. But I get to pick the game.
I'm in.
Okay, let's see them.
Two pair, aces and nines. Three ladies.
Hold it right there, Missy. Full house.
This is fun.
Yeah, you're fun.
Give me the pig. Give me the pig.
Did your mom and dad teach you how to play poker?
Nah, they weren't around that much.
They kind of had their own thing going.
You mean like they worked at crisis centers and built mini malls?
No, more like they checked into crisis centers and bought their beers at mini malls.
Is that why you drink so much?
Okay. Time for bed.
God bless Mom and Dad, and most of all, God bless Edie.
And please let her know, we're trying our best not to screw up.
Jason.
What?
Screw has a bad connotation.
Oh, sorry, God. I didn't mean to say screw in front of you.
You trying to keep the bad guys out?
What the hell are you guys doing here?
That isn't a very nice welcome. Is it, Carl?
I would have to say, no!
Shh! You wake the kids. Come on. Come on in the kitchen.
This is quite the setup you got here, Edie.
Beats jail, I guess.
Yeah. I should think so. That's why I'm glad to be out. Hey, Carl, you glad to be out?
Oh, yeah. There's bad people in jail.
Shh. Told you to keep it down. Do you hear voices?
Yeah.
Of course, now that we are out, we can help you make your sale tomorrow.
What are you talking about?
I got a buyer for the kids. What? What's the matter? You don't look happy.
Oh, no. No, I think that's great.
The important thing to remember is that we got a buyer who's willing to pay top dollar. Carl, give me something to write on.
You really got someone who's willing to pay $19,000 apiece?
No. He's going to pay $50,000 apiece.
That is $100,000 for two little ankle biters. Can you believe it? Pound for pound, that makes him more valuable than veal.
Hey, whoa. Just calm down. You don't want to wake up the merchandise, right?
So who's the buyer?
Here's his name and address. We leave first thing in the morning.
No wonder he can afford to pay so much. He's a doctor.
That's right.
You really think that this, Dr. Wiles will take care of him?
Dr. Wiles?
Shut up.
But
Edie,
Dr.
shut up! Edie, you getting emotionally attached to the merchandise?
No, I just think that if we're gonna sell the kids, we might as well sell them to someone who can take good care of them.
Yeah, well, don't worry about it. The man's a doctor. All right?
Oops.
Go see what that is.
Hurry.
Dr. Wiles, you didn't say anything about Dr. Wiles.
That's because there's nothing to say.
The man is a monster. You have no idea what he's going to do with those children.
When did you start caring for people? You're a mugger.
Hey, I rob adults. 18 or over. Children are a lot different.
No, they're not. Kids aren't any different from you or me. Oh, sure, they may be cuter, but not even that lasts. Well, you should have seen me when I was 8. I was a friggin' doll.
I believe it.
It's fine. They're sleeping.
Good. All right. Give us the best room in the house.
What are we gonna do? Let's wait until they fall asleep.
Oh, well. Look on the bright side, kids. Maybe your new daddy will pay attention to you.
What's the combination?
I don't know. We're trapped.
Hey, let's call Mom and Dad. The number of their hotel's on the fridge. Come on.
Okay.
It's gone. What do we do now? Let's call 911. Answer it.
Hello?
Oh, Joy, Jason. What time is it over there in La Marie?
I don't know. It's real late. Listen, Mom, there's something I really got to tell you.
Uh-huh. Well, what is it, mon frère?
Bonjour.
Edie is trying to sell us.
Jason, when both your papa and I get home, we're going to have a little talk with you and be about lying.
Bonjour. Bonjour.
Now put Edie on the phone.
I can't. Edie's asleep right now.
No, she's not. All right, talk to him. But get him off quick.
Hey,
cut it out. Hello, Mrs. Van Arsdale.
Bonjour, Edith.
I want to let you know that the kids and I are really looking forward to your return. In fact, we've cleaned the entire house top to bottom in anticipation of your arrival this afternoon.
Oh, the twins helped clean the house. The twins helped clean.
Well, no, actually, they did it all by themselves.
Speak up. I thought you said the twins cleaned the house.
Holy Mary.
How did you get them to behave?
Well, guess you'd call it tough love. Okay, goodbye.
Edie, what's going on?
Yeah, Edie?
Shut up and make us some breakfast.
Hey, you don't need to point the gun at
me. Hey, shut up! All right, look, from now on, I'm in charge.
You kids got any Fruit Loops?
I should be riding with the kids.
Elliot thinks you've gone soft.
He's probably scaring to death.
How come you can't drive?
Yeah, never learned. Spent most of my teens in juvie. I think your daddy's clothes look pretty good on me, don't you think?
Your complexion's too pasty to wear pastels.
You know, the only thing that's getting me through this is the fact that we're selling those kids to a quality person.
Yeah.
You ever met this Dr. Wiles?
No, never met him.
But surely you must have heard of him. What kind of a doctor is he?
You know, for an 8-year-old, that Jason sure makes some great lane changes.
If it's money you want, you could just hold us for ransom.
Hey, if I want advice, I'll ask for it. Besides, kidnappers are always getting caught. An outright sale is easier. It's cleaner.
How much are we going for?
100 grand.
Wow. What are you going to do with your 33,000?
33?
Yeah, you, Edie, and Carl are splitting it. Right?
Yeah, well, that's what they think anyway.
I can't tell you. Elliot made me promise.
Carl, we're almost there.
All right, I'll tell you.
All right, pull over.
Perfect. Perfect. Somebody up there must like me. All right, kid, come on, step on it. We're almost there.
Can I see your driver's license, please?
I don't have it. We were at church today, and the sermon was so good that I threw the whole thing into the basket.
I see. The reason I stopped you this morning, sir, is because this vehicle's been reported stolen.
We know that. And we just got it back. Thank you.
Would you both step out of the car, please?
Hey! Stop! Officer, I can tell you where she's going.
What a narc.
I'm coming, kid!
Oh! Take it easy, sport.
Sorry.
Appreciate your help, Carl. The information you've provided will greatly help your case. Right now, I have to return this vehicle to its rightful owner.
don't have to look too far. Open the trunk.
Already straight.
The doctor had planned.
Hello, hello, hello. These must be the children. Nurse?
Bad news, doctor. They're healthy.
Well, we can't have everything now, can we? 100,000, it's all there. Would you like to count it?
If there's a mistake, I know where to find you, right?
Yes, you do. Come along.
What's the doctor doing there anyway?
Where are you? 60 minutes? Hey, look at that car.
I should do society a big favor and pull this trigger.
Edie, don't shoot. You can take half the money.
Half? I can take it all.
Yes, you could. That wouldn't be fair.
You can keep your stinking money. Just stay out of my life. I got something more important to do.
Years of research going down the drain. Thanks a lot, lady. Crying out loud.
Remember when I used to tape your nose and mouth shut?
Yeah. Those were the good old days.
Yummy, 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 yummy. It's so good in your tummy, 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 tummy. So good. Take this and I'll let your brother blink.
What is it?
Cough medicine.
Tastes like candy.
Good. And how are the retinas, young man?
Everything's blurry. Take these things off my eyes. You promised you would if my sister took your lousy medicine.
Promises were made to be broken. The medicine's working.
What are you talking about?
Yeah, that stuff's making her cough.
My, you are unintelligent children. Don't you understand? One product creates the need for another. The makers of traditional cough medicine figure. If they can get more people to cough more often, then those people will need more cough medicine to cure their cough. The only hard part is finding specimens to test things on. Luckily, children like you come along every so often.
You're insane!
You're calling the inventor of cheese breads insane?
Coco! Coco!
Tell that to the corporation and fire me.
Money, 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 money.
I came to get the children back. Jason and Bea, you know, the twins.
Let me explain to you how things work around here. You gave us children, and we gave you money. That was a business transaction. It is now officially complete.
Are you sure about that?
The good folks at Playtime call this one Dodgeball for the Unpopular. Enjoy! Yes!
I'm here.
How did you get in here? My work is secret. Get out!
I want my children.
It's too late!
you. I've been to prison.
Big deal, because so have I.
Picnic to be around. We're sorry too. Let's get out of here.
Hey, Edie, where's the money?
Who cares? I got something better.
Freeze, Edie. You're under arrest. Get down on the ground, child seller.
Jason, B!
That's my babies.
Thank you, officer. We'll take it from here. Our children need us.
Did that horrible, awful woman hurt you?
She's not horrible. She's our friend.
Oh, it's a wig. It's beautiful.
You're not gonna press charges, are you?
Yes, we are, Jason. I'll be happy to tell you why. You're both suffering from something called Stockholm Syndrome. It's where you become attached to the person who's done you wrong.
I'd call you an idiot, but Edie taught me to treat adults with respect. Come on, B.
Certainly is clean around here.
Oui, oui.
Breakfast's ready.
Eat it while it's hot. Here's your napkin.
Sweetie, this looks delicious.
What's eating them?
I bet they're thinking of how much money they'll save now that we don't need a nanny anymore.
Yeah, Mom will probably spend it on a new pair of boobs.
Why don't you go outside and play?
Yeah, I'll even watch.
What's the point of playing?
Yeah, our childhood's over.
Paul, can I talk to you for a minute?
Why should I feel discouraged? Why should the shadows fall? Why should my heart feel lonely and yearn for heaven and home?
Shut up!
When Jesus is my portion and a constant friend is
for his eye is on the sparrow.
And I know he watches me.
Edie, there's somebody here to see.
Oh, send them home.
I see. Because I'm happy.
Yeah, I know.
I see. Because I'm free. His eyes.
Hello, Edie.
The twins miss you.
Jason B., I'm home.
Edie! Edie, yeah, you're back!
But your sweet ass, I am. Hey, what the hell happened here? Geez, I leave for a couple of days and look at this place. Take this stuff up to my room, clean it up, and come down here as soon as you're finished.
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, my goodness. And you could start cleaning down here.
Oh, no. I got bigger fish to fry.
Like what?
Well, for starters, I'm gonna teach you two how to play poker.
Does two pair be three of kind?
No, Dad. Yeah, but wait a minute. Now, a flush is when you have all red, right? Am I right?
No, they have to be the same kind of red. Diamonds are hard to think.
Oh, diamonds. I like diamonds better.
Do you want a beer, Edie?
No, thanks. No touchy stuff. All right, who needs a hit?
I do. Do I need a hit?
Put your cards down.
Well, do I need a hit?
Well, darling,
you
have to figure that out yourself.
Yeah.
This is poker.
Which ones do I need a hit?
You
have to decide,
that's right. Okay, I would like
two
diamonds, please.
Two.
See what I can do. Two there, two east.
Three.
No, darling, you just got your three.
No, these are not two diamonds.
You don't want to show your hand. All right, I'll tell you what, this is a special game we're playing this round. Everybody put their cards down on the table. Except for the dealer. Oops, I win. Okay, money over here, money over here.
Is that
next
the way
round coming up. Yeah, that's how they play in Vegas. Next round coming up.
Okay, more diamonds this time.
See what I can do.
Can we play this every night?
Sure can.
Thank you.
We'll be right back.